Here's the thing, Anson Mount has a podcast too.
Oh, is that
not to be outdone? We'll get to that in a second. He's also on this little show you may have heard of called Star Trek Discovery. And you tell me, when you get a call, hey, would you like to be involved in the Star Trek world? What do you say?
Before I answer that question, I just have to say, I just listened to that weather report. And I live in New York, and I was like, oh, you poor things.
Yeah.
Wind.
Poor.
We have wind.
Say a prayer for us, please.
Yeah, you've spent time out here before. Are we just the wimps here of all time?
Yes. Yeah. Yeah, I realized I was late for a meeting the other day because it was raining. I was like, oh, there's going to be people wrecked on the 101.
Right.
Oh, yeah. So you missed the polar vortex, though. You've been here, right?
Yeah, my wife is not pleased.
And does she call you chattering, or does she, what is she? Or, but
she's
New Yorkers are tougher. Yeah,
she's pretty tough. Yeah,
no.
Yeah, but to answer your question, when I got the, I mean, I didn't actually know. I'd been talking to them last season about the first season captain Lorca, which, and they very wisely hired Jason Isaacs, who I was already a fan of, and then so they called me about this one, but they were calling it the sides. There were dummy sides, and they were calling it Captain Parker. I thought, well, that's a boring name for a captain. So I didn't really know the role that I was auditioning for. And when I found out, I was over the moon.
And when you say dummy sides, for those who don't know, when you audition, you're given a preview of a script. So the actual material.
They're top secret. They're protecting all of their material. So they don't let any material out, including for the people that they're auditioning. So they have to come up with something for them to audition with that's not the actual material, and they're disguising names and locations and things like that. Yeah.
Is this sense of secrecy as you're filming it now still the same kind of thing?
Yeah, it doesn't feel that way when you're there, though. We're pretty well protected, and we just kind of do our thing. But yeah, everything's kept really top secret.
And then the first time you went on The Bridge or whatever it was, this is sort of a 10 years before Captain Kirk. But still, did you feel it?
Absolutely. Star Trek was my make-believe game as a child, right? So when I got to walk on the actual bridge, and I wasn't even in costume, I was just visiting for a makeup test, and I got to sit in the chair, I got a little emotional.
Really?
Yeah, it was just this big full circle thing that I was like, wow, I'm still playing make-believe, and it's what I love.
Yeah. And you've been able to do it and sustain it for quite some time.
Yeah, crazy, right?
Right.
I feel like I got out of school and I put my nose to the grindstone, I looked up and I'm 45.
Mm. Wow, what would that be like? Here's a clip of Star Trek Discovery.
The signals don't seem to be moons, stars, or any other type of planetoid. Truth is, we can't detect anything about them or engage with them in any way. Every time we tried to scan, the computer went haywire.
Like a compass at the North Pole.
Well put. Why didn't we think of that, Connolly? Huh? Think of all the syllables that gave their lives.
The metaphor seemed a bit simplistic.
I believe it's a simile.
Then I owe you a simile, Commander.
Burnham. Michael Burnham.
He said you were smart. We have someone in common.
Yes, I'm aware, Mr. Spock. I was expecting to see him.
Sometimes it's wise to keep our expectations low, Commander. That way we're never disappointed.
That is cool to be part of that. Talk to us about the Well podcast.
Well, I started this in creative endeavor with my best friend a couple of years ago. I being on the other side of the microphone, I'd sort of gotten a little tired of being asked the same questions over and over again. I was being bored with myself, kind of. And I thought, well, what if we have an interview show where we talk to people about the thing that we didn't know that they do? So, for instance, I have an entire interview in the can with Cynthia Rowley, and all we talk about is surfing.
Oh, wow.
But also we branched out from that. So it's about creative thinking outside the box in general. So it's kind of like a radio lab for creativity.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, there you go.
You know, I'm going to give you a pitch. Sam wants to build a canoe. That's really
an episode.
Yeah. There you go.
Nick Offerman.
Yes. I've inspired
you saw
by
the video.
Nick Offerman. Yeah.
Oh, he's
great.
Yeah. I recently bought a house and I realized that I'm into woodworking now. How did that happen?
I know. Star Trek Discovery streams on CBS All Access. It drops Thursdays at 5:30 p.m. The podcast, thewellpod.com. Anson, nice to see you this morning. Jump back here in a minute.
Thank you.